I'm the Vice Chair of Program Operations for USA Swimming, and so it's my privilege and pleasure to welcome you to the 2018 Open Water Nationals. It's going to be a hot meet here, not only in the pool, but by the weather. If you haven't checked, we're supposed to be in the triple digits plus on Sunday. So, hey, it's Arizona, it's summertime, it's supposed to be hot, right?
Right.
Exactly, I like that attitude. Okay, first of all, there's some shout-outs that need to be done here, and they're on the board here. I have my own notes, I wish I had known this would be here. We got the local organizing committee sitting right here in front of me. We've got Ashley and Courtney Warren. Would you stand, please? Give everybody a wave. Obviously, these two individuals have put a tremendous amount of effort into making sure this is a great weekend for you. So we do owe them a special vote of thanks. And then last, but certainly not least, we owe a vote of thanks to Tom Villarreal. Tom is our state and any of you who have been involved in open water competitions in the past, you just know how important this guy's job has been in preparing for our athletes and making sure that when we put 50 in the water, we get 50 out of the water. That's everybody's responsibility. Safety is our number one goal throughout this week.
James?
Never let that slip. Okay? Now, juries. That's the only thing I don't have up here. I've got those names. Okay, technical jury. Coach is going to be Ron Aiken from Sandpipers, the athlete is going to be Ashley Twitchell from Titans, and the coach will, the official will be Mike Murphy from Pacific Northwest. Eligibility jury will be Pam Wilson from Indiana as the official, Joy Field from Texas A&M as the athlete, and Tyler Fenwick from the University of Virginia as the coach. Those will be our jurors. Two of them drew the black bean. That would be Ron and Tyler. They're going to be here to serve on juries throughout the meet. We will change the athlete, obviously, because the same athlete won't be competing in all the events there. Now, the last thing I need to do before I sit down and make a bigger fool of myself is introduce our meet referee, which is Sandy Drake. Sandy, come out here and take a bow.
Thank you, everybody. First of all, congratulations to all the athletes for making it here. The 10Ks were put further on down the line with our juniors. Some of them just qualified because they won their zone event. So we're going to go through a few of the things here. USA Swimming rules, we will be running this meet according to the rules in the book. There are section seven. The gear and apparel. You can wear two caps and the apparel, it has to be a FINA approved suit. We are going to be checking those suits too. If you're not sure, just find an official and ask them. We'll be all around at the check-in. Also under the gear, I'm gonna talk about feed holes for the feeding station. We will be measuring your feed holes and we will be marking them that they are measured. You will not be allowed on the feed station without the mark that our feed inspectors. I'm not sure exactly yet where that will be. Probably close to the feed station, probably right there at the, or on the grass area right by the feed station. We haven't figured out the exact location for that. The watercrafts on, we have on the, how many of the fire do you have the two or one?
We have fire and water. One fire and one PD.
We have, besides, there'll be four official boats, and there will be two police boats on the outsides.
One police boat.
One police and one fire boat. And the fire will also have their safety gear on there for us. There'll also be 8 lifeguards in kayaks and 2 on jet skis going through. Let's talk about a little slipstreaming, drafting, and interference. The referees will be telling you if you're interfering. You will be doing, you will get a yellow card. Look at us. We will have, if you get a yellow card, we will have your number on a board. We'll be pointing at you and with a yellow flag. If there is a red flag, you are to leave the course immediately. Do not stay on the course. Jewelry, watches, fingernails, and toes. Jewelry, you cannot wear those. Please take off your earrings and the rings and all of that. Fingernails and toenails will be checked at the check-in there. They cannot be, so girls do not have manicures. They're going to be cut. We have to have no fingernails. Can't fill like mine here. All right, start times. Report to registration area. For the women's race, its start is at 8 o'clock, and the men's race starts at 8:30. No. We will be at 10:30. I'm sorry, 10:30. Oh, not 8:30. 8 and 10:30. And the registration area, there's going to be a tent set up, and last time I was down there, I'm not exactly sure where. You saw that if you were down there, you saw the barriers, and there were going to be tents set up in there. And if they're not already, the last time I was down there, there wasn't. And we'll be having the briefing. As I already said, the report, your suit manufacturer and model, you're going to be getting your race number when you check in, and you'll be getting your timing chips at that time as well. There will be a pre-race meeting with the lead referees 15 minutes prior to the start of the race, and then 5 minutes prior, we will be doing your parade of the athletes, and you will be given, at check-in, you will be given a ticket, a little slip of paper, and that's laminated, and you are to have that, and you will be parading out, showing your numbers on your hands with the ticket, and you will be giving your ticket to one of the admin peoples prior to entering the water. Okay. The feed station, did you see that little dock? That is the feed station there. And only the people with the feed poles that have been already, as I said previously, marked are allowed on the feed station. So it's small. We don't want it to be crowded in there. I didn't see that you had put that feed station on. Start and finish procedures. We are going to be starting with a rope, and it will be between the feed station and the finish chute where that is. It's going to be out there, and hand on the rope. The rope is going to be behind you. You must have at least one hand on the rope. Finish, when you come into the chute, you all know you have to, you're not finished until you hit the slapboard. If you need to withdraw from the event, if you're swimming and you need to get out, you need to make sure you check in with a boat right that's next to you. You know the distress call, there's kayakers. And once you are back on shore, I need you to check in with the admin, which is Matt Wilson here, just so we know we have the right numbers in and the right numbers out, so we're not searching frantically for you in the water. That's really important. The designated cutoff time for this is 30 minutes after the winner. So if you are not done 30 minutes, we will be pulling you off from the rest of the race. Unless you're real close, we'll let you finish. Protests, you have 30 minutes, is that correct? Right, 30 minutes. to file your protest with me if you have one. As Dan told you, we do have the juries all set. And please, it's good, you can talk to me and or write it out, but eventually I'll have you write out your protest, but you have 30 minutes to do that. Inclement weather, we're not going to have inclement weather, except for Sunday it might be 106. But we'll be out of water before that. So we really don't have anything, nothing is, it's dry, it's going to be dry. Emergency recall signal. Thomas, what are you guys going to be doing if there's an emergency with the safety?
Extractions. Okay. So, as you guys were doing yesterday and today, walking down that boat ramp to get into the water to start your practice swim, that is where we will be extracting any people that really need to get out. So, myself and another one of our safety team members, Josh, will be on jet skis with a sled behind us. Should an event happen, we will have a lifeguard on top of you bringing you in as we ramp you onto that boat ramp and get you out. So that is going to be our extraction point.
Thank you. Recognition ceremony will be immediately following each event. And Sam here yet?
No.
Okay. Sam Hendricks is our announcer and he'll be doing that and probably interviewing you, the winners, as well. One thing I want to say real quick, because I forgot in the rules, I just want to tell, if you've been in the water, you know the visibility is not very good, right? So when you're doing the turns, on the turn buoys, make sure it's clear that you went